نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Before starting this lesson, I would recommend that you go through all the lesson from lesson 1 to 9 because we will be using what we have learned there and apply it over here because the phrases will use all the knowledge so far that we have covered. So let's do the phrases. That what will we cover in phrases is the phrase, that what exactly a phrase is, and then we will talk about the descriptive phrase. Now before using the phrases, let's bring some signs so that we can easily identify it. The first sign is that we will be writing rafa as an arrow. That means it will be pointing from bottom to the top. And the nasab we will be writing is the arrow which will be coming from the top to bottom, and it will be in this color. And the jar would be shown as an arrow from right to left with the orange color. For mufrad, that is the singular, we would be using S sign. And for muthanna, that is the dual case, we will be using the sign of M. For plural, we will be using the sign of P. And for the indefinite nouns, we will be using the sign of I. And for the definite nouns, we will be using the sign of D. And for the masculine, we would be using this sign. For the feminine, we will be using this sign. Now, we have to apply those signs on here. Let's see how it works. Rajulani, as we know that this is ani sound in here, so it's a dual case. But let's see it first. It is indefinite noun because there is no al in there. That's why we have to show it as an I. It is a masculine one, so therefore we have to use a sign of that. And then since it is a dual case and it is a musanna, that's why we have to use M over there. And lastly, as it is in rafa, so we will be using this arrow for it. So if you see such a word, and then we will be representing them with these simple signs, like when we see I over there, that means it's an indefinite. If you see this sign, that means it's a masculine. And if you see M over there, that means it will be a dual case. And lastly, when we see this sign, that means it's in rafa. Now, so far we have used singular words. That means they were mufrad. And when mufrad and mufrad comes together, that means when two singular words comes together, they would form a murakkab, literally a compound. So two nouns or two words when come together, they would form a phrase. Let me show an example of the phrases that the two noun can make. The first one we come across would be the pious boy. The second one is the boy's book. The third one is this pen. And the fourth one is in the room. The fifth one is this is a boy. These are all the possibility of the phrases when at least two words come together, they make a phrase. If you look at these phrases, you can see that they do not convey a complete message. So they are basically a kind of incomplete phrase, which are called as murakkabi naqis in Arabic. If you look at this last part, which is this is a boy, it conveys a complete sense, and this is what we categorize as a murakkab tam, or we can call it a complete phrase. We will be taking a start from these kind of a phrases, and then we will move on to this, and then this, and then this, and finally to this one. Now let's start with the pious boy. The pious boy is incomplete phrase. Now there are two parts in that one. The first one, which is an established noun which is already there and you are attaching some description with it, we will call this noun as mosuf. So that's the first part of this phrase, that this is called as the mosuf. The noun that describes this mosuf is called as the sifat. So that sifat is basically the description of this boy. This sifat could be bad or good. You can say a good boy, or you can say as a bad boy. So in both the cases, you are describing this noun with this noun. So there are two parts. One of them is the sifat, which is the description, and another one is the mosuf. Now, in a descriptive phrase, one noun describes another one, and most of the time, this sifat is an adjective. Before moving into the construction of these kind of phrases, let's see how exactly they have to behave. Mosuf is a noun, and we know that the noun has all the four aspects. One of them is the extent, gender, number, and case. We have described these things in the previous lesson. This sifat has to follow all the four aspects of the mosuf. That means this sifat has to follow the extent of it. If this boy is definite or indefinite, this sifat has to be definite or indefinite. If this boy is a feminine or masculine in the gender, then the pais has to follow the masculine or feminine of the boy. If this boy are two, singular or plural, then this pais has to be two, singular or plural. And lastly, if this mosuf is in rafa, nasab, and jar, then this pais has to be in rafa and nasab and jar. So that means that the sifat has to follow all the four aspects of the mosuf. Now let's construct it. Let's open it up. That's the pais and that's the boy. And this is your sifat and that's your mosuf. Now if you look at this flow, in English, the flow is that the sifat comes first and then comes the mosuf. That means the description first and then the mosuf. In Arabic, that thing would be totally opposite to it. That means that mosuf would come first and then it will be followed by the sifat. So if you see it from the Arabic side, you would see it as boy pais. Now in this case that you're seeing it, this mosuf is the first and then the boy. So now we need the vocabulary to construct it. The word for boy in Arabic is waladun. You have to make it definite because there is no some, any, or a boy. So this is a definite one. So we'll make it a definite. And then let's apply those signs that we have done it in the beginning of, which was this definite. This one is masculine. That is a singular. And it's in rafa. So this boy is definite, is masculine, is singular, and is in rafa. Because that's the four aspect of this noun, so these four aspect of the noun has to be followed by the pais. Now let's bring the vocabulary first. The pais is called as salihun. Make it definite then. So it will be as salihu. Because it's a solar letter starting with a solar one sad, so it has to have a shadda. As-salihu. And now it is masculine already and it is already singular and it is in the rafa state. So our construction is ready, we just have to join it, and it is also in the form of boy pais. If you look it from this side, that means boy and pais, we just join them. It will be al-waladu salihu, and you put al-waladu salihu, and you can see that hamzatul wasl vibration has gone because you are joining it. So your construction is ready, and that is the final one for pious boy, al-waladu salihu. Now remember, this is a descriptive phrase where one noun describes the another noun, and it is an incomplete phrase. Now let's take another example from the feminine side. That is the pious girl, and Arabic it will look like girl pais, and for girl we use bintun, and this girl is definite because you don't see any some, any in front of it, so it's a definite one. So let's make it definite. So al bintu, and it is feminine, it is singular, and it is in rafa. So these are all the four aspects of this noun. The first aspect I'm going to take is the feminine one. Feminine of the salihun is salihatun. Make it definite, so it will be as salihatu. And it is already singular and it is in rafa, we just have to join it. But before doing that one, we have to bring that shadda over there because that's the solar one. And now you join it together, and that would be then albintu salihatu. And it is albintu salihatu, and that vibration has to go because that's the hamzatul wasal. When it joins, that vibration has to drop. You would write the hamzatul wasal, but you would not pronounce it. Let's take another example from the Muthanna. You have got two boys, pais. When you see it from the Arabic side, it will be like this. That is two boys. And now you have to bring only the vocabulary of it. And the two boys are waladani. There is no some or any two boys. So that's why it is definite. So make it definite. It will be al-waladani. And that is the masculine one, Muthanna. And then it's in rafa. So we have to bring now the pais, which is then salihani, because it's the muthanna. So I'm bringing exactly salihani as a muthanna case of it and make it definite, it will be al-salihani. When you put that shadda over there, because it's a solar one, it will be as-salihani. And now it is already in rafa and it is the masculine one. So we are done with the construction. We have to just join them together. When we join it, this hamzatul wasl has to go because it will be written and the vibration has to go, but it will not be pronounced. So it will be al-waladani salihani. Take the muthanna example from the feminine side. So you will see it in Arabic like this, like two girls spies. Now two girls are al-bintani and already have done it a definite one just to avoid the steps. Then this is the definite one and it's feminine and it's muthanna and in rafa. So I have to bring the pies as a muthanna one and the definite, and then that would be as-salihatani, but that is a solar one, so you have to put the shadda, so that would be then as-salihatani. And when you join it, the hamzatul wasl would act and you would have al-bintani salihatan. So now bring something from the plural side, which is the pious boys. That means it's a masculine plural one, and if you look at it from the Arabic side, it would be like boys pies. For single boy we use waladun, for plural we will use as awladun. So the case is not a singular one, but it is awladun, and this is the masculine. And to make it a definite one, because there is no some or any or a something in front of it, that's why it is definite. So make it definite in Arabic, so it will be al-awladu. It is already in rafa. Now the pious has to follow all these four aspects of this noun. For the pious we use salihun. A plural of salihun is salihuna. When you do the definite one, it will become al there, and it's a solar one, so it's already that shadda over there, and it's a masculine and it's in rafa. So or all construction would be then al awladu salihuna, because that hamzatul wasl has to act and that sign has to go. It will be written but it will not be pronounced. So that is al awladu salihuna. Here an important thing that you need to remember is that in English we use the boy for son as well, like my boy. Ibnun is used as for my son. The plural of ibnun is banun. Now let's take an example from the feminine plural, which is spies girls. When you look at from the Arabic side, it will be girls spies. And now for girl we use bintun, and it's a feminine one. Let's make it a plural because it's a girls, banatun, and make it a definite one because is there no some or any girls, so it's just the girls, so that means it's al banatu, and it is already in rafa. So these are all the four aspects of al banatu. And now the pious has to follow all these four aspects. When you do it, it will be as salihatu, and when you join it, it will be then al banatu salihatu. And that's hamzatul wasl has to. Now we'll be taking some example from indefinite, which is some pious boys. When you look at from the Arabic side, it will be then some boys pious. So you see the some over there, that means it is an indefinite one. For a single boy we use waladun, and that is then the masculine one. And if you wanted to make it a plural because it's the boys, it will be awladun. Is already indefinite one, we don't have to do anything with it, and it is the rafa case. And it is indefinite because there isn't any al in there, so that's why you would see it as indefinite. Now the pious has to follow all the four aspects of this noun, which is it has to be indefinite, it has to be masculine, plural, and in rafa. And the appropriate word is now salihuna, because salihun is just the singular one, and if you make it a plural one, that would be then salihuna, and it is a masculine and in rafa. When you bring it together, that would be then awladun salihuna. It will be awladun salihuna, and there is dun over there because you haven't used indefinite, because if indefinite is used, then tanween has to go. As I told you in before lesson, that the tanween and al do not coexist. Let's take another example, which is some pious girls, and this time it is the feminine one. So when you see it from the Arabic side, it will be some girls pious. This time is the feminine one, and that's the bintun. You make it plural, and that would be banatun. And when you put indefinite one, it is already indefinite, so you don't have to do anything, and it is in rafa. So the all four aspect pious has to follow, that is salihatun. So that when you bring together, that would be then banatun salihatun. Now let's take example from Quran, which is straight path. And for path, we use siratun. For path, we use siratun. And let's make that one definite, because it's not some path or any path, it is a specific. So put al in front of it, it will be al-siratu, because that sot is a solar letter, that's why that shadda has to come, and you have to read it al-siratu. It is a masculine one, it is singular, and it is in rafa. So the straight has to follow all these four aspects of this noun. Straight in Arabic is called as mustaqimun. Straight in Arabic is called as mustaqimun. Now apply these all four aspects on the mustaqimun, you have to make it definite. So it is al-mustaqimu. It is already masculine, it is already in singular, and it is already in the rafa. So our thing is ready, we have to just join it, and that would be as-siratul mustaqim. This construction is made in rafa. Now we can put it in this table as in rafa nasab and jar. We have done the as-siratul mustaqim. So if you wanted to put it in nasab, then it will be as-siratul mustaqim. Mustaqim is the rafa, mustaqima is the nasab of this, and as-sirata is the nasab, as-siratu is the rafa, and similarly as-sirati is the jar, and al-mustaqimi is the jar of it. So only the vibration has changed, otherwise the thing is the same. So when you change the cases, that means the meaning would not change, only the vibration would change. And that's what you see it in Quran in Surah Al-Fatiha, chapter number 1 and verse number 6. And you say that اِهِدِنَا الصِّرَاطُ الْمُسْتَقِيمَ. And that is basically a construction. This phrase has been used in the nasab case. So this اِهِدِنَا الصِّرَاطُ الْمُسْتَقِيمَ. And we have done now, this part of it is a phrase. This is something else that we will be covering later on as we go to the verb. If I want to take another example, which is why is Quran, then Quran is read as Quranun, and that's the rafa of it. And you wanted to make it definite, so it will be Al-Quranu, and that is the masculine one, singular, and then rafa. And now to use the description of this Quran, which is the vice has to follow all these four aspects of the Quran. So Hakimun is used for wise. Make it definite one, that would be Al-Hakimu. It's already masculine, it's a singular one, and it's rafa, so our construction is ready. We just have to join them together, and it is Al-Quranul Hakimu. Now take the cases of it. We have that one made in rafa. We wanted to put it into nasab and jar. The Quranu and Hakimu has gone to Qurana and Hakima, and it is gone into jar by Qurani and Hakimi. So that is Al-Quranil Hakimi, Al-Quranul Hakima, Al-Quranul Hakimu. And that's what you see it in Surah Yasin, chapter number 36, verse number 2, where it has been used in jar, Wal-Quranil Hakimi. Now things would never go into cases without any reason. That means there would be some reason which pushed the things to the jar case. So here you see that wal Quran al Hakimi. So it was basically al Quran al Hakimu, but something before applied to it, and now it's gone from rafa to the jar case. And as we go within the course, we will unfold some reason for that why the things changes the cases and why they goes into nasab and jar, and that's what will be coming in the next lessons as we proceed within this course. Example, which is a just ruler, and this time we are taking this example from hadith. It's a just ruler, and that's why it is indefinite, because you see that a over there in front of it, and then when you translate it, a ruler is imamun in Arabic, and it is indefinite one, it's a masculine, it's a singular, and it's in rafa. So if you wanted to bring the just adilun, it has to follow indefinite, It has to be masculine, it has to be singular, and that has to be in Rafa. So I can see all those four aspects already in there. So I can just join it and it will be Imamun Adil. I'm not going to show you the Arabic text of that one, but I can show you only the English translation of it. But as we proceed to this case, we will be covering part by part this whole hadith and bringing the Arabic text, and as well would be translating our own version of it. So let's have a look. And that's the hadith which is taken from Sahih Bukhari, Kitab al-Adhan, hadith number 629. If you can see that, it's been narrated by Abu Hurairah, which said that the Prophet wasalam, says that on the day of Qiyamah, that means on the judgment day, there will be no shade. There will be no shade. It will be totally without the shade that day. Seven people can benefit from the shade of Allah. First category is the Imamun Adilun. The person who is a just ruler, he will get the shade. So that would be the first one, would be a just ruler. The second one would be a youth who has been brought up in the worship of Allah. And the third one would be a man whose heart is attached to the mosque. Two persons who love each other only for Allah's sake and in part in Allah's cause only. A man who refuses the call of a charming woman of a noble birth for illicit intercourse with her and says, I am afraid of Allah. A man who gives gifts so sincerely that his left hand does not know what his right hand has given. And finally, a person who remembers Allah in seclusion and his eyes are then flooded with tears. So these are the seven people who will get the shade at that day. It's a very hard day, brother and sister. To get that shade, you have to come at least into one category. We cannot be in one of this category because everybody could not be a ruler. But you can find your place among one of them and you can fit anywhere. So Allah will help you out in this case, but just go and search the way you can fit in and just try for that to be. Now, next we can go to cursed devil, and that's our fourth example. The devil is shaitan, and if you make it a definite one because there is no some or any, it's only the devil, that's me a shaitan. And you see the shadda over there because sheen is the solo letter, so ash-shaytanu, definite one, and then it's the masculine, a singular, and an rafa. So all four aspects has to be followed by this cursed. Now cursed is ar-rajimu, and that's again ra is the solo letter. That's why you see the shadda over there when you put the al in front of it. So ar-rajimu, and now when you join these together, then it will the hamzatul wasl. Only it has to be written but not pronounced, and the vibration has to go, so it will be ash-shaytanur rajim. Now if you put them in a different cases, we have done the construction in the rafa case, if you wanted to see the nasab of it, it will be ash-shaytanur rajim and ash-shaytanir rajim. So these are the three cases of it. Take this ash-shaytanur rajim and put a min in front of it. Now look at the min. This is a rule. Whenever a sakin letter joins with something, it normally takes kasra. But in case of the nun sakin of min, and it is an exception, whenever the nun sakin of min joins with something, it doesn't take a kasra, but it takes a fatha. So this is only an exception, that whenever nun sakin of min joins with something, it takes fatha. Otherwise, any other letter which is sakin joins with something, it will take kasra. And you see that one in the ta'awuz, which is a'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. And here you see that it takes the fatha. But in normal case, when there is a sakin letter, any sakin letter, if it is noon or anything else, but the noon shouldn't be from the min. Noon should be with something else. So that means whenever it joins with something, and then it will take the fatha. So as we move on, we will look at some of the exceptions. But first exception that you have got now for the nun sakin is that whenever it is in min, it will take fatha. Let's take another example, which is a great success. Now a great success is an indefinite example, and you can see it as a success is fawzun. And now this one is indefinite one because you see that ah there, and then it is a masculine one, it's a singular, and then rafa. When you want to look for the great, then it has to follow all these four aspects of it. For great we use adhimun, and there is already indefinite one, it is a masculine one, singular, and in rafa. So we are ready to join it. it will be fawzun azeemun. So far we have made this construction in rafa. Now you can make it in nasab, which will be fawzun azeemun. Now these are the three different cases of fawzun azeemun, where in rafa it is fawzun azeemun, and nasab it is fawzan azeeman, and in jar it is fawzin azeemin. This and the nasab has been used in Surah Al-Ahzab, chapter number 33, verse number 71, where it says that يُسْلِحْ لَكُمْ أَعْمَالَكُمْ وَيَخْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَمَنْ يُتِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ فَاذَ فَوْضًا عَظِيمًا. And it says that يُسْلِحْ لَكُمْ, that he will amend for you, أَعْمَالَكُمْ, your deed, وَيَخْفِرْ لَكُمْ, and he will forgive for you, وَذُنُوبَكُمْ, your sins, وَمَنْ يُتِعَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ, and whoever obeys Allah and his messenger, فَقَدْ فَاذَ فَوْضًا عَظِيمًا, he has certainly attained a great attainment. And you can see the faza in another verse, which is from chapter number 3, verse number 185, where it says that كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِكَةُ الْمَوْتِ, says that everyone shall taste death. وَإِنَّمَا تُوَفَّوْنَ أُجُورَكُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, and on the day of resurrection shall you be paid your wages in full. فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازَ, and whoever is removed away from the fire and admitted to paradise, he indeed is successful. وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَطَاءُ الْغُرُورِ, the life of this world is only the enjoyment of deception. So far we have covered all the possibilities that can happen with the descriptive phrase. Now let's take some description of things. A quality is also called as description. So I'm going to take some qualities, which is hasanun. For the masculine is hasanun, but if you want the feminine of it, it will be hasanatun. And salihun, the quality for the mu'annas or for the feminine would be salihatun. Akhdaru, that's the color. Akhdaru, that's the color. For the feminine, you have to say khadra'u. And ahmaru is also a color and it's a quality. And hamra'u, another one, asfaru. And that for the feminine, yellow would be safra'u. And aswadu is used for the black, for masculine. If you want to use it for feminine, that would be sawda'u. Beside these, if some people are disabled, then disability is considered as also as description in Arabic. So abkamu, and that bakma'u, akbaru, kubra'u, azgaru, and that would be sughra'u, ahsanu, and that would be husna'u. One of them is a disability. As I told you, the disability is also considered as a description in Arabic. And there are other things, that something like great, youngest, or the best, they are also considered as a description. So these are some descriptions that I have collected in these tables. You can remember them. We will be using some of them. Now let's take an example from Quran. Now we can look for this construction, which is a yellow cow. You see that is a cow, which shows that it is an indefinite. For cow, we use baqaratun. And that tun, that is the tanween, would show us that this is an indefinite. It's a feminine, it's a singular, and it's in rafa. So now the sifat has to follow all these four aspects of this mosuf. And the word that we can find for color, the feminine color, is safra'u. Our construction is ready, and it is then baqaratun safra'u. This construction has been used in chapter number 2, Surah Al-Baqarah, verse number 69. Before looking at this construction, let's look at the background of this verse. It is in Tafsir Ibn Kathir that Ibn Abi Hatim recorded that Ubaidah As-Salmani saying, "There was a man from among the children of Israel who was impotent. He had substantial wealth and only a nephew who would inherit from him. So his nephew killed him and moved his body at night, placing it at the doorstep of a certain man. The next morning, the nephew cried out for revenge, and the people took up their weapons and almost fought each other. The wise man among them said, 'Why would you kill each other while the messenger of Allah is still among you?' So they went to Musa alayhi salam." This is the verse number 69. But if you go back to verse number 67 and 68, there are a lot of arguments between Musa alayhi salam and those people who came for to find the killer. Musa alayhi salam said to them that Allah commanded that you should slaughter a cow. And they replied that, "Do you make fun of us?" But Musa alayhi salam said that, "I will be among the foolish, or I will be among the ignorant if I make a fun of you. It's just the command from Allah, then you have to follow it." And that's what it follows in 68, 69, that they are asking about the color of the cow. The cow, if you see that here, till this verse number 69, is an indefinite one, which is Baqaratun Safra'u. As you go down further to 70 and further verses, they made it definite by asking the color of the cow and the other features of the cow, because there was only one cow at that time which had that feature, and that man didn't want to sell that cow. It's further then recorded that that cow was then put into the scale on one side and the gold was put onto the another side. So that man who had the cow was compensated for the gold. And what happened to the cow then? They slaughtered it, they took a piece of it, and then struck that piece on that dead man, and that man came to life and said that my nephew killed me. And that was the whole story about that cow. But what here is that a Baqaratun Safra'u is indefinite one, but if you wanted to make it definite, that means if you wanted to put Al in there, then basically you would be defining it more exactly to the point, which exactly happened in these following verses from 70 onward. Now let's take another example, which is Holy Land. A land in Arabic is Ardun, and you make it definite one, which is Al-Ardu. Al-Ardu or Ardu is a feminine. So it is a definite, it's a feminine, it's a singular, and it's in Rafa. Now we'll be looking for all these four aspects of Ardun to match with the holy. So let's look for it, and that would be then Al-Muqaddasatu. That is Al-Muqaddasatu. So if you join it, that will be then Al-Ardu Al-Muqaddasatu. And that Hamzatul Wasal has to act, and that vibration has to go, but you have to write it, but you don't have to pronounce it. So it's Al-Ardul Muqaddasatu. And then you can see it in a different cases, and you can see that this construction is used in Nasab and Surah Al-Ma'idah, chapter number 5, verse number 21. Now, before bringing a very important rule of the Murakkabi Tawsifi, let's divide the creatures group into two main categories. One of them would be the intelligent creature, where you can put the human, jinn, and angels. And the another one would be the non-intelligent creature, where you can put the rest of the creatures. The important rule of the Murakkabi Tawsifi is that if the Mawsuf is a Jama Mukassar of non-intelligent creature, that means here, then the native speaker take mostly sifat as a singular feminine. Now let's take an example so that you understand it. I'm taking it some new pens. Now that is some pens, which is the indefinite one, and pens is jama, that is the plural, where we can found a broken plural in Arabic as aqlam. So pens, broken plural in Arabic is aqlam, because it's some, so it is an indefinite one. So, and then it is masculine and it's a plural and it is in rafa. A jama mukassar is there and you wanted to use it and to a murakkabi tawsifi, then the sifat has to be a feminine singular. And that's what will happen here, that you are looking for indefinite, because that's indefinite, so you have to look for an indefinite one. You have to look for singular one, and that the word we can find it for the new is jadidun. So to make it a feminine one, you have to bring it as jadidatun. And that's what will be the whole construction of it. It has to be in the rafa. And now it will be aqlamun jadidatun. Now you can see in this case that we have the construction aqlamun jadidatun, where aqlamun is the jama mukassar of non-intelligent creature. And that's why we have used the feminine. So it doesn't have to follow the plural. And that's the very important rule of the murakkab tawsifi that you have to remember. Application of this you can see in Surah Yusuf, where it says that abwabin mutafarriqatin is used in the jar. But you can see that abwabin is the jama mukassar of babun. And babun is a non-intelligent creature. And that's why you see that the sifat is used as a feminine singular word. Now let's apply all our knowledge that we have learned so far and put it, and let's see that if we can understand some of the bits of Surah Al-Ghashiyah, where it says that hal ataka hadithul ghashiyah wujuhun yawma idhin khashiyah amilatun nathiba tasla naran hamiyah تسقى من عين عانية ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة آلية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمارق مصفوفة وزرابي مبثوثة. Now you can look in these verses from verse number 1 to 16 that there are murakkab tawsifi in different cases. So here it has been in nasab, here you can see they are in jar, and here they are in the rafa case. So let's take them in turn. First of all, naran hamia. You can see that the naran is indefinite one, it's the feminine, it's the singular, and is in nasab case. Naran is fire in English. Now we have to look for the all the four aspects of this noun fire to find a word in Arabic that is hamiyatun, which is indefinite one, it's a feminine, it's a singular, and it is already in the nasab. Now hamiyatun in English is hot or violent, so altogether that construction would be the hot fire, which is a violent fire that blazing. Another one is Aynin aniyatin, and that, if you remember, aynin or aynun we have used for eye, and also we have used it for water spring. Here it is being used in the context of spring water, so it will be then indefinite one. It is feminine, and it is the singular one, and it is injured. Now we have to look for all the four aspects of that that the sifat has to follow, and that exactly it follows. If you look at it, it's an indefinite one, it's a feminine, it's a singular, and it is in the jar. Now let's bring the translation of it. N is a spring water or water spring, and then aniyatun is the boiling. So if you make that construction, it will be a boiling water spring or a boiling spring water. Another one is jannatin aliyatin. And now if you look at that, jannatin is indefinite, it's a feminine, it's a singular, and it's injur. And these four aspects are automatically followed by this sifat. Now the jannatin or jannatun in rafa is a garden, and aliyatin in English is high or raised, so it will be raised gardens or a high garden. Another one is aynun jariyatun, and that is used in rafa. If you look, that is indefinite one. Aynun, as you say, that it's again the feminine one, is the singular and in essence rafa. So it is a water spring, and jariyatun, it has to follow all these four aspects, which you can see it's indefinite, it's a feminine one, it's a singular, and it's in rafa. So the English for jariyatun is continuously flowing, or the flowing water spring, and that is the construction. It would be a continuous flowing water spring. Now take another one, which is sururun marfu'atun. Now here you have to apply that rule of the murakkab tawsifi. As I said, that it is an important rule of murakkab tawsifi. If you look at that, sururun is a broken plural of sarirun, and it is an indefinite one. It's a masculine and it's a plural, but it's a broken plural, and that is in rafa. Now if you look at that sifat, it follow exactly that important rule, that it is a feminine and it is a singular. So sururun is a thrones. Since this is a broken plural, so the sifat has to be a feminine singular one. So that would be indefinite, it would be feminine, it has to be singular, it has to be in rafa case. The marfu'atun is raised. When you join them together, it will be a raised throne. Now take another one, which is akwabun mawdu'atun. Again, the same thing would apply. Akwabun is indefinite, and that's the masculine one. It's a plural, but it's a broken plural. So again, that thing would apply, and it's in rafa. Now, that akwabun is a jama mukassar of kawbun, which is cups. And now, mawdu'atun is indefinite. It's a feminine. It should be singular, and it has to be in the rafa case. So the mawdu'atun is then the setup in a row, or properly set up cups. So they would be then well-placed cups. And now another one, zarabiyun mabthuthatun. And that is then indefinite, masculine, plural again, and then in the rafa, that is carpets. When you look for the other one, which is a sifat, it will be indefinite one, it will be feminine, it will be singular, and an rafa, and that is spread out. So it is the spread out carpets. Another one, which is namarikun masfufatun. You can see it's indefinite, and that is a masculine. It's again the broken plural, and in its rafa. So the cushions is for namarikun. Now it has to follow the indefinite one. It will be feminine because it's a broken plural, and that has to be singular, and then in rafa. So the word that we can look for is masfufatun, and that is then lined up cushions. So you will see them as lined up cushions. And that was the last construction that we have made. Now you've got an exercise that you have to go through, where you can find the identify the mawsuf and the sifat in the following verses, and then write the cases, i'rab. In different cases you have to write it, gender and extent you have to write it, and then translate to the descriptive phrase only into English. So this has been taken from the different surahs, you can see that. And lastly, the second question, which is study Surah Al-Waqiyah, which is from chapter number 56, 1 to 42. Look for the descriptive phrases only and check the meaning of the noun. So I will see you in next lesson. Sadaqallahul Azim.